creating comedy based on an improvised documentary that you all are going to help them build. Get your hands clapping. Make some noise for Pop-Up Improv OKC!
Thank you. Thank you for being here this evening. We'd like to start off this evening with a seasonal number. I'm sure some of you may be familiar with it. And if you are and you're so inclined, please, please join us. Sure if that was going to work. Hi, good evening. We're Pop-Up Improv OKC. I'm Dan. Thanks to our soloist, Jennifer. Let us meet the rest of the band.
Connie.
Yeah.
You still Jennifer?
Oh, Jennifer. Yeah.
Hi, Brian.
Yeah. And I'm Susan.
Great. So, as Kenan said, we're going to work off a couple of made-up documentaries. To get things started, we'd like to give a suggestion, a one-word suggestion that related to the holidays.
Gingerbread.
I heard gingerbread. We're going to start with gingerbread. That's what we got. In a moment, gingerbread.
It was the smell that got me, let me tell you. Walking down Fifth Avenue, every holiday season, I'd walk by that little bakery and there she was in the window. But all it was that smell. She took my arm! She took my freaking arm! I couldn't help myself. It just, every little smell, but every little bite was just so good.
Down a dastardly hole of addiction, and now here I am on the street in front of the bakery shop, and they don't sell gingerbread anymore.
They should have warned me about the dunking.
I can't swim! But did I tell you before I even fell into addiction? The first time I took my hot chocolate, marshmallow goodness on top. And I got that little gingerbread cookie and I just took it in there, and then it was the gingerbread with the marshmallow with the chocolate. It was just more than I can handle.
I'm so tired of working on the holidays. How you doing, Christmas tree?
Oh, I'm fine, Reef. Can I bum one from you?
Yeah, just a sec.
You got a light? God, I've been hanging by my neck all day in the cold.
You know, and there's people that try to, you know, like put their heads through me. You know how that feels?
You know those pokey things they used to hang on you? They hang on me too, and it's like all around, and gravity's pulling on places I wish it wouldn't.
Look at this big stupid bow they got on me.
Oh, Xmas tree, that's last year's bow. God, these people are cheap.
Oh, just rub it in. Just rub it in. Yeah. I've got a little toy train over here. That's probably from 1950.
I remember that train. That was the kid's train. Now he's all grown up. I wonder if he remembers us as a kid.
I don't know.
Cut to
Betty Boop.
30 years ago.
Oh, this is the happiest time. The kids are happy. The train is happy. I love being a Reef. Don't you love being a Christmas tree?
I do. I can do like this and everything shakes and jingles and it's just happy, happy, happy.
They hang stuff on me and I feel proud.
They hang stuff on me and I say, yeah, baby.
Decorate.
Put it right there, baby. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow.
The people who live in this house are so loving.
These are the best things ever. I wonder where the presents are.
Hey.
I hate this house.
I love this house.
Come back to present.
I hated that fucking house.
I loved it.
I'm not even sure I know what to do with that Christmas tree. It's quite a turnaround. You were so happy. So happy.
How the hell do I get up here?
Well, Cat, when you're old Cat, you just have hip problems. Maybe somebody should help you.
Just because I'm short doesn't make me a cat. By the way, Santa's been an asshole today.
Well,
he's
our break's almost
an
over.
Yeah. But this is time for the elves to
come
by.
This?
Thanks.
Tree Chopper, he's the best.
Well, back to work.
Gingerbread. You got any gingerbread, man? hey man, you got any gingerbread? Shit. Excuse me, you got any gingerbread, man?
I might. What's it worth to you?
Linda here.
Oh, you're gonna give me away for some gingerbread?
I'm losing it, Linda.
Turn around for me, would you?
Turn.
What else you got?
I'm not even worth gingerbread anymore.
anymore. You told me we were gonna go to the big top. You told me we were gonna go all the way down Fifth Avenue and that we were gonna find where all the real money was.
Take a look at my wares.
Don't leave yet.
That's just some knockoff sugar cookie. That's not even the real thing.
What? I'll take the knockoff sugar cookie at this point.
But it's the roll kind. It's not even like handmade. It's the grocery store.
You don't understand my desperation.
I do understand your desperation. I've been living with you for 30 years.
I didn't know you married the Pillsbury Doughboy.
Come on, Linda. I don't like the sound of that guy anymore.
Let's see. James Dixon?
Yeah. James Dixon, that's me.
Welcome to Holiday Candy Anonymous. We really appreciate you coming forward. The first step is always so hard.
Yeah, I took the first step. I made it here.
I understand you're addicted to peeps.
I am, peeps. They're so good, they're so squishy, you know.
They make you hop around like a bunny, huh?
They did.
Yeah.
They did. It all started back in
Easter.
Easter. It's progressed.
Well, I don't know. You seem a little cute. You're not really hopping that much like a bunny. Okay. Go check in with Miss Rogers. She'll take care of you.
This is take care of my bunny. Okay.
Oh. Jim Johnson, huh? You're addicted to candy corn. Which is candy corn myself today. You know? Go check in with Miss Rogers. Yeah. You're addicted to yourself. Very self-centered, you know? It's a problem these days. Yeah. The peep to the peep.
Those of us who have addictions for candy come to cure our ailments.
Oh, you're right. But I think you're missing in the wrong crazy house. I think you're looking for Pirates R Us.
Oh, I thought this is where the Three Musketeers were. Okay.
Well, with inflation up, gingerbread sales are down this year. The industry's taking a beating. And we're gonna have to mobilize to make sure that gingerbread continues to be a holiday staple, not just at the holidays, but at all the holidays. Every one of them.
It's the only thing I make for Christmas is gingerbread, and they've run out of the ginger and the bread stuff because it's in the recipe.
It was necessary due to forecasts made on sophisticated computer modeling for us to purchase the entire planet's supply of ginger and bread stuff and to hoard it in our large warehouses that look like tank farms so everyone's okay with it.
I asked Mr. McCormick if it was gonna be and pulverize it and mush it and grease it and just get it down to that perfect particle that goes into my cookies.
We released a statement to the family on behalf of the McCormick family. We read it to them. Of course, we X'd it to them. That's the tweeter thing that's got the tweeter. And we still use it because it promotes all of our proper values. Meanwhile, we do have all the bread stuff and ginger.
And I'm still waiting for my letter. The only electronic thing I have is my fancy KitchenAid mixer. It does all kinds of things. It turns ginger and bread into gingerbread. Magically.
We provided the family with a lifetime supply of new stand mixers, kitchen utensils, plates, knives, silverware, glasses, cups, kitchenware. They don't need any of that stuff, but we gave it to them anyway. Because, if you don't have a livelihood, at least you can pretend to eat.
And we're having a yard sale on Sunday. 2222 East Main Street.
We're going to buy up everything she owns.
I have my ways.
I have my ways.
To rub it in everyone's face that you can pay full price. I tell you, generic is just as good. You know, the door was just wide open, so I walked right in. I thought I'd be the only one here for the open sale.
No, you're not the only cheap ass.
Well, at least I gotta ask. Oh.
Hello. Welcome to Aldi. I see you found our value lane here, so just feel free to pick up whatever you want here, because I'm tired of stocking this shit.
It's my first time here. I've never gone into this.
Watch the cars.
So is this where the really cheap stuff is?
Lady, it's all cheap. It's Aldi, okay? But this is where the really, really cheap stuff is, especially if you go down here on the bottom lane down here, the bottom shelf down here, right?
Ooh, look at those.
Ooh, this is perfect for you.
Yeah, it was from Easter. Yeah.
Oh, that's great. She likes to pretend a lot, so this is all right along her.
All right.
Madam, shall I keep the Hyundai running?
Would you like this peat box? There you go. All right, so we've got a generator right here. I mean, it's good for you. I mean, you can have this, right? Yeah, we got that.
There's a
swing.
Generator.
There's a children's swing set right here. Yes. Yeah. $99.
Advent calendars.
Whoa!
What? It's that. Pre-holiday, holiday, post-holiday, but pre-holiday sale.
Everybody knows at Aldi the advent calendars never go on sale.
These are from last year.
We don't care, we're German.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. And remember, don't blow pom. Good
night. Give it up for Pop-Up Improv OKC. We still having a good time? We are just about ready for our headliners. We're going to get set up here in just a minute. But while we do that, we're going to take a quick intermission. And before we take that intermission, we want to let you know we offer classes here at OKC Improv. And you can have all the fun that we're having. That's correct. All you have to do is go to OKCImprov.com, click on the classes link, and sign up for our beginning improv class. They are so much fun. It's 2 hours out of your week. You choose a day of the week that works great for you, and that's your class for the next 8 weeks. At the end of that 8 weeks, you get to do exactly what we're doing. You get to do a show for friends and family. So it's going to be so much fun. And while that may sound nerve-wracking right now, our student shows are actually some of the most fun that we ever have here in this theater. And also, a little extra plus is once you're registered for classes, you get into as many shows as you want absolutely free. So go take advantage of that by going to OKCImprov.com, clicking on classes, signing up for our next round of classes. If you have a friend that you're like, I think they might be interested in this, we also have gift cards that you can go on the website and purchase as well. It's like a preloadable gift card, and so they can spend however much money you decide to put towards that, they can put that towards their class. So you can put the amount that it takes for a full class, or you can also just put half of that, whatever it is that you want to offer for that. You can totally do that, and it's so much fun. It's a great gift. We've had multiple people that have gifted that to their friends, and I promise they will not regret it. We also offer teen classes if you're like, become a better human being, 13-year-old. We can do that for them. If you're worried about the future and some high schooler like cut you off in traffic, give them a car. Tell them to come to OKC Improv. We'll make them a better human being. Or we'll at least let them yes and your road rage. So either way, it's rough. Like I said, we're going to take a quick intermission. Bathrooms are down here. Go over to Amanda. Say hello at the bar. Go buy yourself a shot. Tell her Kendon sent you. She will give you a shot. You will pay for it because that's how transactions work. So make sure you go do that. When we come back, we'll have our headliners, which depends on you to guess who's going to be riding on Santa's sleigh this holiday season. Don't go anywhere. We got reindeer games coming up.
Yeah. to see.